know, we're going to have to work our way to building our own wealth and creation. Can you just go into a little bit on the blessing, the giftings, and the callings?
Right. So one of the things God has given us that falls under the banner of salvation being the solutions is wealth creation strategies. And so, you know, there's been a big fallout in the body of Christ, you know, when it comes to the prosperity gospel, you know, and you know, we had our conversation previously about, what constitutes the prosperity gospel. And you asked, what was the question you asked? I can't remember.
So what I was trying to do is I was trying to figure out what.
Don't forget your question, but we got to get to this one first.
I got a question.
Oh, you led into what we were talking about. That's right.
Yes. So I was trying to figure out what the exact differences were between the prosperity gospel and what we're talking about right now.
Right.
And what I condensed it down to was that the prosperity gospel is built to focus on what God can do for you.
Right.
Right. Without you having to do anything other than
right.
Put money into my ministry's hand.
Yeah.
So if you tithe, you keep tithing me every week.
That's all I'm. That's
God me. Is going to move in your life.
Yeah. Come on. They get excited. See, they get it. He's trying to get it. He caught the spirit in the thing. He caught that. He might get it.
That's how it goes. You know what I mean? They start pumping you up.
Yeah.
God's going to move you up. That's right. God's going to move for you. People start, you know, they get wild with it.
You hit the nail on the head.
But what we're talking about is a step-by-step process through education, preparation, execution,
right,
to build yourself into wealth.
Right. Amen. The Bible says it like this over in Deuteronomy 8:18. He says, I've given thee the power to get wealth or to become wealthy. Like, that's not a get quick rich scheme.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Right. The prosperity message has been associated with a get quick rich scheme. And in essence, I wouldn't call it that, because there's a degree of evil in that I don't think preachers, or most of them, some of them have, but most of those who were part of what they call the prosperity gospel. The reality of it is the gospel is a message of prospering, right? On every level, spiritually, soulishly, physically, psychologically, economically. So it's you can't preach the gospel without talking about prospering. It is a prosperity message in itself. But when you focus it on the financial aspect of things, you have to be more comprehensive than what most prosperity gospel preachers were. You just described exactly what most prosperity gospel preachers preached or taught. It's give to my ministry and God's going to bless you. But they don't go into the dynamics or the how-to knowledge of how God blesses us individually, corporately, nationally, you know, within generationally. They don't go into that. They didn't break that down. Again, generally speaking, some of them went into it. But most of what they labeled the prosperity gospel preachers didn't go into that. All they told you was, you know, if it wasn't the tithe, it was a special offering. $50 line, $100 line, $200. Guys told me there's 10 people in here that's going to give $1,000, right? So, and you do that, then God's going to open this door and go. But it was very vague. It wasn't enough information, not comprehensive enough. Well, what God wants to do is reveal to us his wealth creation strategies. He's given us some things that will aid us or were designed to bring us into that wealthy place. Psalm 66, verse 12, he says, thou hast caused men to ride over our heads. We've went through the waters, we've been through the floods, but thou hast brought us out, and you leading us into a wealthy place. There's a place of wealth creation that God has for you. There's assets that come along with our salvation that we have to learn to leverage. We have to think entrepreneurially. We can't think get a job. So there's a lot of things that go into teaching and building up believers to build wealth the way God would have them to build wealth. That's why we created the Building Wealth God Way portal, and we flooded it with videos that has all of the insight and the wisdom of everything that goes into creating generational wealth and building generational wealth. God is a remunerator. That word remunerator means to make another wealthy. He says, he that cometh unto me must believe this about me. Over in Hebrews, the 11th chapter, the 6th verse. He must believe this about me, that I am a reward of those who diligently seek me. Oh, there it is right there. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh unto God must believe that he is, and he is a remunerator of those who diligently seek him. I'm looking to make you wealthy. That's the idea of that word remunerator. It was known in its day as a kingmaker, one who was looking to make another kingly. And you can't be no such thing as a broke king. Right? God wants us wealthy so that we can be the public servants that God has called us to be as the church. He wants the church to rule. Well, what's one of the criteria for ruling? Wealth. The rich ruleth over the poor and the borrower servant to the lender. I mean, it's everywhere in the Word of God. Like, we can give you scripture after scripture after scripture, right? But we have to go from being turned off, because I was on Twitter the other day and folks was dogging out, you know, the black preachers that migrated from the civil, the civil rights gospel to the prosperity gospel. And they were comparing Martin Luther King's message to some of the modern day preachers' messages. And so they were coming down hard. But it's not that God doesn't want us prosperous. It's not that God doesn't want us wealthy. It's how God wants to make us wealthy. I think we gotta grasp that. And so when we talk about God being a remunerator, looking one who looks to make you wealthy, the question is how? Now it goes back to what you were saying. I just thought about three things for this particular podcast. The first thing is the blessing. Proverbs 10, chapter 10, verse 22 says, the blessing of the Lord, it maketh rich. In other words, the blessing is on assignment. The blessing, like, it's on an assignment to make you wealthy, right? That word blessing is the word for benediction. Where we get the idea of pronouncing the blessing over the congregation when they leave. Well, it's much more than that. It's a proceeding blessing. It's a proceeding confirmation from God that you hear and how to navigate through life and create wealth and take advantage of opportunities and seize moments to help you build wealth the way God would have you to build wealth. The blessing, it has an assignment to bring you into wealth, and not only just bring you into wealth, but bring you into it without the sorrow, without you making poor decisions and losing everything. But you got to be in tune with the Spirit. You got to walk with God in your wealth creation strategy. Can't be something that you just do off the top of the dome. Right, you got to have an intimate relationship. Everything is about intimacy. So, you know, first thing we talked about was the blessing, which makes one rich and don't add any sorrow. And that blessing operates on the spiritual level, the soulless level, and on the financial level. God is something on you. It also means the propensity, right? The blessing is, it gives you a propensity to do great and mighty things. It gives you a propensity to think through. It gives you a propensity to be wise. See, that blessing, is there's no limits to how the blessing functions and operates in your particular situation. But it has one goal in mind, to make you rich, to make you wealthy. Now, I know that's a far cry from what we call the blessing in a lot of places, right? Right. We talk about the car and the house and all that. But and again, nothing wrong with that. But there's a deeper thought process in what God had in mind when he put the blessing on your life. He had something else in mind. He wanted to give you the propensity and the capacity and the magnitude and the fortitude to fight and overcome whatever you got to fight and overcome to get into that wealthy place that he has for you. So that was just one of the first things that I wanted to mention when it comes to the assets that God has given us. That's the blessing, and how the blessing operates in your life. It'll take the average person and enable them to do great things, right? It'll take the person who couldn't and enable them to do when they couldn't do before. So when we're talking about the blessing, we got to get beyond the physical manifestation of it, but we got to look at the spirit of what the blessing does. It makes you rich, and it eliminates anxiety. It eliminates fear. It eliminates worry. It eliminates the frustration. You just got to walk in it. And when I say eliminate, that's probably not a good depiction of what I'm saying. It's more, it enables you to overcome anxiety and overcome stress and deal with it and manage it properly so it don't affect the way you build wealth or doesn't get in the way or cause you to stumble, right? Because you go through certain circumstances where fear might try to stop you from doing something, or anxiety might come upon you when you think about making a decision. But we have something that's greater than anxiety, something that's greater than fear. And we got to understand that that's how the blessing operates in our life. It's going to give me the ability to overcome those things.